What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. With EA basically retiring the Origin app and the EA app taking over, it's going to become important that we can install and run that here on the Steam Deck. Now, right now, the main way I've got this working is with Lutris, so we're going to take a look at that, but I got a couple other things to talk about here real quick as well. The other method of sideloading and adding a non-Steam game to Steam and installing, as we've done with other launchers, doesn't work yet for the EA app, at least not for me and not consistently. I've tried all the compatibility layers and I continue to test them every time there's an update so that if eventually it does work this way, I'll have a video for it, but so far I haven't been successful. I keep getting different errors and things where it wants to update. I can get to this point, but once we need to launch the actual app, I'm not able to get that to work, and it'll try to update, then fail out, and come back to this again. And these errors change too, but either way, haven't gotten it to work. Now, through Heroic, I really wanted this to work, but I got it installed, but when I launch it, I was coming across issues with my credentials. And I went on Reddit, and it seems dozens of people are having the same problem, where when you log in here, it locks you out, and you have to reset your password. After 4 password resets and trying every workaround I know, and talking to EA support, I just wasn't able to get this working on Heroic. I've seen others get it working, but I haven't, so I'm not going to cover it here in this video yet. So let's get on to what does work. We're going to use Lutris. So with your Discovery app, you're going to want to go in and search for Lutris in the applications and get that installed if you haven't already. So you can see it here popping up on the screen. I'll go ahead and click install, and once it's done, we'll just click launch and close out of the Discovery app here. Now, if you want to see a slower, more in-depth install of Lutris and how to set it up a little bit, I have a prior video. I'll link in the description for that. Now let's go ahead, get into our settings after I pin this to taskbar, and I do want to switch this to dark mode so my eyes don't bleed while we make the rest of this tutorial. So there we go. We'll use dark mode and go from there. So what you want to do here is go to the plus button up here on the left to add a game. We're going to go to search the Lutris website for installers, and then we're going to type in EA app or EA desktop, and this should bring up the option to install the new EA app. This works pretty well. I've done it with 2 different Steam Decks, and so far it's been a pretty consistent experience. So I'll click on here and we'll get ready to install the EA app. Now you get some prompts to go through here, so we'll go ahead and install that. It's going to install it in Home Deck Games, EA Desktop. That's fine. We'll install Continue. It's going to download, so we'll continue. And that's fine. Now, once we get a little bit through the process here, I did run up against an error that I was getting repeatedly after this Wine install with the dependencies with error code 256. I tried a lot of things to get it to fix, and nothing was working until someone suggested to me something pretty simple, and I don't know if this would work for everyone, but I went into the settings and toggled prefer system libraries on and off, and I turned on the disable Lutris runtime. Basically, by doing that and restarting Lutris, I was able to get past this error 256. So if you do have that problem, try that and see if it works for you. But these things can be a bit finicky when it comes to setting up on the Steam Deck. So once I did that, I went through that same process I just showed you, and then we didn't have any of those hangups at that point. It was able to go right through here, install the dependencies, and then everything was working fine. So again, that was suggested to be to me to try, worked for me. If you guys run up against that error, give it a shot and see if it helps you out. All right, so once that's finished, we'll be able to launch our EA app. So I'll go ahead and click launch here. And you'll also see that now down at platforms where it says Windows, where I have Epic already installed, EA app now automatically shows up there. So this launched for me just fine, but when I got to the login, it said temporary connection lost. It did this on both Steam Decks, but all I had to do was wait a few minutes and then it popped up for me to log in. And unlike Heroic, I was able to log in every time without any problem with my password. Everything loaded up just fine, able to get into my collection, see all my games, my Play subscription and all that. So EA app definitely working great here for me through Lutris and tested on 2 Steam Decks. I'm going to go ahead and install Need for Speed Unbound, a game that I definitely wanted to try out on the EA app here. I've been playing it over on the Steam version, so we'll click download. I'm using the internal SSD for everything. Not a big fan of the downloading speeds and some of the performance with third-party apps here on the Steam Deck yet, so I do prefer the SSD here. So I'll just let everything work that way, and we'll go through our normal install prompts here. All right, I don't need a desktop shortcut, so I'll uncheck that. I'll click next, and then everything will go through its normal process to install again. Once I got to Lutris, I didn't have any problems installing, running the EA app, and installing my games. So once that's done, I'll close out the EA app, closed out Lutris, and I'm going to go ahead and add this to Steam so we can use it in game mode. So I'm going to open up Steam, go to add a non-Steam game, And Lutris will show up right here in the list for you because it is a native Linux app. So add selected programs. We'll go ahead and scroll down and you'll be able to see Lutris down here. Now, I'm going to go ahead and add all my media icons in here so it looks nice. I have a video already for doing this. Again, it'll be in the description below. I want to save you guys some time in this tutorial. But once all that's done, I went back to game mode. And here you can see Lutris is in game mode showing up for us just fine with all of my proper media. Now, something I show in my other video as well is I switched to gamepad with mouse trackpad so that I can actually move around in the app. And then trackpads, the right trackpad, I changed over to have left mouse click so I can actually click on things. Otherwise, you have to use the touch screen when you're in Lutris and the EA app. If you want to see that more in depth, again, link will be in the description for my Lutris install guide. All right, so this boots up really fast in game mode. Lutris has been working great there. And I can click right on EA app now with my trackpad, click play, and then we'll get launched into our EA app. Now I'll just leave this real time for a minute here, and it doesn't take very long. Lutris launches very fast in game mode, and then when you launch the EA app, it's actually pretty quick, and it remembered my login information from the desktop, so everything was good to go here. So I'll just give that a little bit longer here, and there we go. Now once this loads up, you'll be able to see the Need for Speed that I had started downloading on desktop. We allowed that to finish earlier, so that'll be ready to go here, and then we can launch Need for Speed. So we'll click this here. And again, it doesn't take that long. I feel like the process here with the EA app and Lutris, that things are actually running quicker than they do when I just sideload directly to Steam. But we'll see. But anyways, we're launched into Need for Speed Unbound here. And I gotta say that so far anyways, my testing with the EA app on Lutris, their performance of games, and I've had time now to try a couple of others, has been pretty decent. So I'm really looking forward to testing more games here and maybe doing some comparisons to the Steam versions, but this is definitely a great way to be able to start using the EA app since the Origin app is going to be no longer used by EA going into the future here. So anyways, guys, I hope this helped you get set up with Lutris and your EA app on your Steam Deck. Thanks a lot for coming to check out the video as always, and I'll see you guys in the next one.